One of my favorite festival foods is the gyro. Yes, for years I mispronounced it. It is actually the gyro. But how do you reproduce that at home? Well, I have got a recipe that you are going to love. It is my Gyro Meatloaf. It's made with ground lamb and ground beef, Middle Eastern spices. It is a large quantity, so it will serve many people, and you are going to be thrilled with the taste and the outcome. So let's get started with my Gyro Meatloaf. For this recipe, you'll need 1 pound of ground chuck, 2 pounds of ground lamb, 2 shallots finely chopped, 1/2 cup medium bulgur wheat softened, 2 tablespoons za'atar, 1 tablespoon kosher salt, 1 teaspoon ground pepper, 1 teaspoon garlic powder, 2 tablespoons dry parsley, 3 eggs, and olive oil. This meatloaf assembles pretty quickly. I've preheated the oven to 375, and I've softened the bulgur wheat. The bulgur wheat is what is used in tabbouleh, a very popular Middle Eastern dish, and I usually get my Middle Eastern spices at Gassane's. They have a very wide selection. This is a medium bulgur, and it's quite coarse right now, but all you have to do is add it to warm tap water, and you'll see that it expands. It only takes a few minutes. And before we begin, we'll just mix together all of these ingredients. The chopped shallots, we'll put that in a smaller bowl. And then we'll also add the za'atar. Now, I make my own za'atar, which is a combination of sesame seeds and sumac, which is a lemony, deep, deep purple spice, and thyme. I like the fresh thyme rather than the dried thyme, but you can usually buy the za'atar already assembled also at Gassane's. So we'll add this, it's 2 heaping tablespoons, to the shallots. We'll add the salt. Try to use kosher because it does blend better. The ground pepper, the garlic powder, and the dried parsley. And now all we'll do is just mix this together. All right, so now things are going to get a bit messy. I better remove my wedding band. All right, so we'll add the mixture with the shallots and all the herbs and spices. We will add our eggs, 3 eggs. And now we will add the bulgur wheat. And this is very easily drained. All you do is give it a good hard squeeze with your hand to extract the water, and then you just add that to the bowl, because you really want to make sure you squeeze out all the moisture. And now we'll give this a really good mix, and the best way to do it is just get in there with your hands and thoroughly blend this together. I prepared the loaf pan by spreading some oil all around the surfaces, and now we are going to pack in our Gyro Meatloaf. Look at this. It looks beautiful. It really is going to fill up this pan, and you want to make sure you pack it in. So now what I'm going to do is just make a little well right down the middle. It's all packed in. And I'll take the olive oil and just pour it right down the middle, and then rub it all over the top to prepare it before we put it in the oven. Our oven is preheated to 375, and we'll put that in for almost an hour, about 60 minutes. And what would an authentic gyro be without tzatziki sauce? So while the meatloaf's baking, let's put this together. For the tzatziki sauce, you'll need 1 cup of plain Greek yogurt, juice from 1 lemon, 3 cloves of garlic chopped, 1 English cucumber, seeds removed, 1 tablespoon of fresh mint and or dill chopped, and kosher salt and fresh ground pepper to taste. Nobody likes soupy tzatziki. So after I peel and deseed the cucumbers, I wrap them up in paper towels to absorb the moisture. And see, it's only been about 5 or 10 minutes. And look at the moisture that has already been absorbed. So now they're much drier and it'll make for a chunkier sauce. So we'll remove that and I'll just chop these up lightly. Now we'll add the chopped garlic, the lemon juice, and couple tablespoons of fresh chopped dill. You can also use mint. I really like both of them. Or you can add both dill and mint to this sauce. But I thought the dill looked really nice today at the store. So I picked that up. Oh, just love the smell of dill. And now a couple grinds of fresh ground pepper. We'll add salt later because we don't want to draw any more moisture out of the cucumbers. Now we'll just put this on and give it a good chop. Now how easy was that? We'll just add this to the Greek yogurt. Well, as you can see, this is one beautiful meatloaf and it tastes just like a Gyro. And you can serve it formal at the table by the slice, or you can load up a pita like I am about to do and just put the trimmings on it. Tomatoes, I'm gonna put some cucumber, and of course top it with a little of my homemade tzatziki sauce. And right here at home, I am going to enjoy a Gyro. And it isn't even festival season yet. Oh, I cannot wait to bite into this. This is gonna be a little messy. So let's see how it tastes. Mmm. It is so good. You are gonna love this. I'm telling you, this makes enough for 6, 8, 10 people. You can slice it as thin as you want or as thick as you want. Mmm. And I think a Gyro calls for a nice IPA to wash down all those wonderful flavors. Delicious. Just go to my website, CaseyMaloneShow.com, for the tzatziki and for the Gyro meatloaf recipe. You are gonna thank me later. Cheers.